Seigneur.
This is the scripture that is in the poster. Chapter 12, verse 18. We thank God for the word. The man of God preached a very powerful word. Is it not nice to have a friend that can preach?
Yeah.
You can, when you talk to him. How many of you heard Dakaro when he was preaching? Like that, you know? My friend is my motivation. I want to grow in English and I become like him. I will be teaching about oxymoron very soon. Hosea chapter 12, verse 13. I want to describe to you what is the purpose of the night of
eating.
Why are we here? How did it start? What did the Lord say about the night of vetus? It is important.
But
we are not just doing things. Our lives are directed by God. We need to move when He says we should move. Stop when He says we should stop. We are not just doing.
I said it.
If you can learn to do as you are directed, allow Him to lead you. Hear from Him. Move when He says move. I believe you will supply by His grace that particular vision. You see,
we are born.
It is a great treasure when you have come to that point wherein God is guiding your steps. The Bible says the steps of a righteous man, they are ordered by the Lord. Those are the steps of a righteous man. It's not like when you are righteous, automatically it happens. You are righteous and you allow the Lord to order your steps. Remember the words of David. David says, your word is a lamp unto my feet. If the steps of a righteous man are
ordered by the Lord,
then a righteous man should be hearkening unto the word of the Lord. Because if David says he's a lamp unto my feet,
it
is therefore guidance of where you should go. Are you getting what I'm saying?
We are Muslim.
We should all strive.
We
should all pray that our lives should be guided by Him. When God guides you, you are not in competition with anyone. You are running your race. You know what is your purpose. You know what is the vision. So I will say some things. But let me read this verse first. 12:13, the book of Hosea. This is one of the good prophets. You remember how his marriage was? Let me leave that. Verse 13. And by a prophet, the Lord brought Israel out of Egypt. And by a prophet, was he preserved. When it says by a prophet was he preserved, it's also talking about the very same Israel. Israel was delivered by a prophet. And by a prophet, Israel was preserved.
Israel also a clean one.
So, I hope, look at me, all of you.
Beginning on.
This is not a very difficult verse. I believe. Look at
how this prophet is giving out a prophecy. In his prophecy, he said, by a prophet, the Lord delivered
Israel.
Even that statement on its own tells us that a prophet is a definition of deliverance. A prophet is a definition of deliverance. Are we together? Are you here on Zoom? Can I get an amen? Don't sleep. Can I get an amen? Check your neighbor. Kind, very kind. Respect that person. Tomorrow there might be a millionaire. Shake them very hard. Shake the other neighbor. With respect. Amen. You're shaking someone's husband, someone's wife, so be careful. So listen to me. Why did God say we must do the night of verdict? What is the whole thing of the night of verdict? I am not. It's not like I always get an opportunity to explain why we have the night of verdict. Most of the night of verdicts I go and then I present a subject and then we start screaming and everything that we do. Yeah, the Holy Spirit must touch you and you must scream one day. Don't be too complicated. But it is of a necessity that we should understand the whole purpose and the whole aim of the night of verdict. Are we still together? Can I hear your amen? When you are led by God, learn to follow.
Fall down London.
You see, I was led by God to do the night of verdict. And we have done many night of verdict. This is just one of them. But when you say to people, when learn to listen to what God says you should do.
Now
to
find food out London.
We are all going to be thinking.
Song said Abana.
Minister. But in actual sense, like we listen to God in everything. You saw when I was talking about my wife, I said, no, she not drink. I wasn't saying that you shouldn't listen to God. And I'm also not saying that you should now go stay and then you say maybe to the sound like a
superman.
But it is important that we all learn to receive instruction from the Lord. Not only about maybe what you have to do in life with ministry, purpose, preaching, singing, even about your life. Tell them never learn to listen to God. Touch that sister next to you and say, so what did God say about him? So I want you to say to the sister, I see he's in your prophet picture already, but what did God say about him? Who is Israel? Israel is the seed of Abraham.
Israel is the seed of Abraham.
In that Abraham gave birth to Isaac.
Lapho uthu Abraham wazala uIsaka.
Isaac was a very good man.
UIsaka wayindoda elungile.
Even he's a very good man.
Indoda ekahle.
His father even realized.
Ubabakhe wasuyaqonda.
That my son is good.
Ukuthi indoda nayo amikahle.
I don't want him to be married anywhere.
Angifuna ayoshada noma yikuphi.
I will get him a wife.
Ngizomthwalela unkosikazi.
Those are good fathers.
Labo ngabobaba bahle.
But you know,
kepha
some of us
abanye bethu
they can say hey But his father found him a wife. He was loved in the first sight. The moment Isaac looked at he fell in love with her.
Was Tana,
who is the wife of Isaac?
Rebecca.
And then now he looked at her and he loved her. There is another verse in the book of Genesis that says, and when Isaac was meditating, he saw Rebecca. Do you know a verse like that? That tells us about the power of meditation. You know, when you have mastered meditation, you have mastered the prophetic. You can actually sit down and visualize the future. I used to think that this guy was, I mean, imagine he meets a lady, the first date is like, wow, I love you. Like, it's because he saw her during his meditation time. During our days where you have headsets and everything and phones, where it's always noisy, make time for God. And don't only make time when you are only talking to God, reading the Bible only. Also make time for meditation. I've come to realize when I live with many people that it's very difficult for people to keep quiet. And it's very difficult for people to survive in quiet places. Because you can actually go to the church and they are playing music, and you arrive wherever you are, they are playing music. And when you come out of wherever you are, you have headsets. And you have time for meditation. Imagine when you are during your meditation time, you are sitting down and you visualize. Maybe that's the reason why the brother is still alone. Lack of meditation. Because the more you meditate, the more God reveals. Listen,
Lalela.
Meditation is important. At least in a week. Have a quiet time. You are not on your phone. You are not chatting to anybody. You are not lying to anybody. Because the people that chat the most
lies the most.
The moment you are on WhatsApp 5 hours, you are about to say a lie.
5 hours,
because the truth didn't need that time on WhatsApp.
It
will be wonderful. I'm talking about Isaac. Love on the first sight.
He
saw it on meditation. Meditate. Are you getting my point? I mean, Let me ask you a question. When you meet something or someone, and then you love something or someone, you are not quite sure if that's the right decision. And that's the significance of meditation. Because when you have a quiet time, you think it through.
The
Holy Spirit will communicate to you.
The
Holy Spirit will give you direction. Those sisters that listen to headsets the most, they are the ones that break up the most. Think about it if you have headsets. The thing is that you have even said yes to what you have not think about. Anyway, I'm just trying to achieve a force to force you to meditate. You will. Now we are thinking about something that you didn't do originally.
Okay.
Meditation is the answer. Please. Check your neighbor and say meditation.
Meditation.
You know, I love my sons and daughters.
Some
of them, even at the two, I see them in WhatsApp. This guy is a minister. Okay, these things are good, but give yourself time with God. The effectiveness of your calling is from the time that you have spent in the secret place with the Lord. Hence, many
are
get my point. So,
imagine
Isaac,
Esau,
is the son of the promise.
No, that I say is.
Let me say this because you know my issue is I must show you Israel.
You come
and how Israel. They were delivered. And how they were preserved. Then I start deliverance and preservation.
No,
you don't know end in deliverance. You end with preserved. I was saying to my wife, the Bible says, I was teaching her. She's a good student. I teach her until I forget that she gets sad. She will remember me. Not these short sermons, long sermons. Long! I explain everything, even the map in the Bible, I explain it. You remember the sermon I was preaching on the map? You remember
each other
behind the Bible?
Yeah,
explain everything. That's also for those my daughters that want to be married to a man of God.
Now, my daughter, because I'm a full son, I take a good home.
Check the daughter next to
you.
Hallelujah. Now, listen to me. The Bible says obedience is better than. Do you remember Abraham? If you read Genesis chapter 12, you will realize that the Bible says the Lord had said to Abraham, that means God has spoken to Abraham. But
Abraham
had not yet obeyed. Remember, obedience is better than. Remember what was the instruction? The instruction was leave your father's house. Leave your country. Leave your relatives. Go into a place that I will show you. I will bless you. I will make your name great. I will bless you. And it shall be a blessing to all the families of the earth. Abraham, at first, he was not obedient to that word. So for that word to be fulfilled, God needed a sacrifice. When the Bible says obedience is better than a sacrifice, it is not saying sacrifice is worse, because with most people they don't obey God, so what they need is a sacrifice. Because I've realized that sacrifice has been made to be something which is evil. But God is saying, if you don't obey, what can talk for you is sacrifice. That's why God said to
Abraham,
I spoke to you. You didn't obey me. I don't trust you. Before I bless you, sacrifice Isaac. When Abraham was in the process of sacrificing Isaac, God wanted to prove if Abraham was ready to hear.
Abraham
took Isaac, put him in the altar, ready to chop him. The angel had to see in the heart of
Abraham
that Isaac was about to Abraham was about to kill Isaac. The angel had to say, wait. And you read Genesis chapter 22, there is a verse where God says,
Genesis chapter 24,
for now I know.
Kuti manje ngiyazi.
You fear the Lord.
Uyamsaba uNkulunkulu.
Obedience is a proof that you fear God. When you don't obey the Lord, you live a life of sacrifice. And when you don't obey the Lord and you don't sacrifice, you live a life of poverty. Because nothing is talking for you. You don't obey the Lord, your sacrifice will help you. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Before people attack sacrifices, the question is, can they obey the Lord? Because if you don't obey the Lord, sacrifice would have to speak for you. It is a language in the spirit.
We
did an uplift. People were required to bring a sacrifice. And even today, people are still sending me to my father, God is working in my life. It is simply because you were not obedient. So you were taken through a process of sacrifice. Hence, in the days of sacrifice, I told the people, we are going to go.
You
remember that day? You remember that night? How cold it was.
Because
the sacrifice night. You still can receive the same. From obedience. I'm sure that few people obey God. I can see it in their life. I'm just telling you about Isaac. That the reason why God wanted him from Abraham. You see,
Abraham.
Like I said, Abraham was going to receive a name that nobody has here on earth, only him has it.
Abraham,
even us, we are called his children. That's how big God wanted to bless the guy. So that sacrifice, God wanted to prove, if I'm to give you these things, will you give them back to me? Because disobedience is unfaithfulness to God. Disobedience is like when you have employed someone and you say this is a procedure of the company and they choose to do the other way. So for you to prove if they can obey, sacrifice is the way. Like the things we disobey, or the things we choose not to do, are the very same things which, if we do, there is life. You're thinking,
we
are thinking. You don't shake your neighbor. Don't say anything. Just shake them. Don't even smile. Just shake them. Say obedience. Why the Zulu says this other song? They have another one. Fasting, let him not be out of disobedience. Then you'll end up with, let me leave that one. Because if you know you don't obey God, then you know fasting is the way. For you to receive anything from God, you have to fast. You don't obey Him. So you have got to sacrifice. When you are busy, hungry, yeah, you are like that thing that.